على أشرف الخلائق أجمعين محمد.
الله صل على محمد وعلى محمد.
الحمد لله مالك الملك مجري الفلك مسخر الرياح فالق الإصباح ديان الدين رب العالمين. الحمد لله الذي من خشيته ترعد السماء وسكانها وترجف الأرض وعمارها وتموج البحار ومن يسبح في غمراتها. الحمد لله قاسم الجبارين مبير الظالمين مدرك الهاربين نكال المستصرخين موضع حاجات الطالبين معتمد المؤمنين. الحمد لله الذي يخلق ولم يخلق ويرزق ولا يرزق ويطعم ولا يطعم ويميت الأحياء ويحيي الموتى وهو حي لا يموت بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير. الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله لقد جاءت رسل ربنا بالحق ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله بشيرا ونذيرا. والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الخلائق أجمعين محمد
اللهم صل على محمد.
قال الله العزيز في القرآن الكريم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وقال ربكم ادعوني أستجب لكم إن الذين يستكبرون عن عبادتي سيدخلون جهنم داخرين. الله سبحانه وتعالى as he said in the Quran Kareem, pray to me for I shall answer you prayers. Those who are too proud to worship me will soon go to hell. And this grace. Sadaqa Allahu al-Aliyyu al-Azim. Brothers, sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ask us to pray for him. Ad'uni astajib lakum. Ad-du'a mukh al-ibadah, the brain of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Without prayer, there is no way to really be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Surah Al-Ghafir, which is the name of the Surah Mu'min also, is one of the seven surahs start with the Hammim. Hammim. And this surah with the seven surahs as a team, there are so many hadith about them, about importance of this surah. Therefore, we need to look for really reciting these surahs together, or memorizing, understanding, and certainly the surah, Surah Hammim. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has seen al-hawasim, Taj al-Qur'an, these seven surahs. They are the throne of the Quran al-Karim. And the other hadith said from Amir al-Mu'min Ali, لكل شيء لباب. For every matter, for everything, there is lubab. Lub is the brain of it, or most valuable things in it. And lubab al-Quran al-Hawasim. And the brain of the Quran al-Kareem, these hawasim. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-hawasim, Rayhan al-Quran. As for example, somebody has his son called this is the Rayhan. I mean, he's so, they when they smell them, when they look at them, his kids, he feel comfortable. And the Quran, the Rayhan of the Quran is Surah Al-Hawasim. Okay? فَحْمِدُ اللَّهُ وَاشْكُرُوا بِحِفْضِهِمَا. The hadith say, praise Allah and be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you are reading this Surah and memorizing this Surah وإن العبد يقوم بقراءة الحواسين when the man, when the servant start move to recite this surah, فيخرج من فيه طيب. From his mouth it will come out special smell. Okay? And that is no smell better than this kind of the smell. وإن الله لا يرحم تاريها وقارئها. And Allah will bless, surely, the one who recites this surah. ويرحم جيرانه. And he will bless the, his neighborhood, his friend, his relative, everybody who loves him too. When you recite this surah, okay, everybody will gain the blessing and help and benefit of you when you recite this surah. النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم has said, من قرأ حاسين غافر. Whoever recites this surah, حاسين غافر, سورة الغافر, okay, لم يبقى روح نبي. They will not be other than or like that. Every soul of the Prophet, okay, and Siddiq, the one as Ali ibn Abi Talib, ولا مؤمن, and all the believers, إلا صلوا عليه واستغفروا له. They all will pray for him and ask Allah forgiveness for him. This is the benefit of this surah. The surah, these are seven surah. And another hadith says, the gate of the hell, seven. When you read the surah, all the gates of the hell will block. Okay, that means you will never go to the hell. Because you are reciting this, brother and sister, focus. These are not mine. This is the offer from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to you all. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to bless you. But he offer you an offer, a nice offer. You just need to consider. You just need to accept this offer. Allah promise. And whatever Allah promise is there. You know, when we talk about Allah's promise, in the verse of the Quran, Allah has said, وَيَسْتَعْجِلُونَكَ بِالْعَطَىٰ. Okay? Some people, because they were so arrogant, they said, if Allah is there, I don't believe in Him, I don't worship Him, let God send His punishment toward me if He is here. Allah has said, no, we promise not to punish here. We have later on the day. That's a promise of Allah. If somebody come and challenge Allah, Allah and the Quran say, no, we do not break our promise. Not now. Later on, there will be a day, okay, equal to the 1,000 year of your dunya time. That means Allah never, okay, break His promise. Therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He said, اِدْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ, pray for me, I will answer response positive to your prayer. Allah is sure say the truth. We need to move and accept this offer. And we need to schedule our life in the way to deal with the offer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not ignore whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala offering you, brothers and sisters. Teach your kids about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala offering dua, pray to Allah, supplication, asking Allah, communicating with Allah. What is important things? Brothers, sisters, without Allah, we are zero. We are nothing. Okay? Therefore, we want to gain something, we have to join Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caravan. Accept whatever Allah offering us. Therefore, we need to build our life in the way really match with the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala offer. Allah wants us to pray, okay, to Him. Allah wants us to remember Him. اذكروني اذكركم. Remember me, I will remember you. Okay, why not? Many people are waiting for the special time when they have hard time and hardship to pray. Many people, they are waiting for the special place to go and pray. Many people are waiting for the special age to pray. Many people are waiting for the special condition, hardship, problem, difficulties, needy condition to pray. This is all wrong. Why we should do that? Okay? Why we should do that? That's not right. That's not fair with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because Allah is available everywhere. We don't need to wait for some place to go to pray. We don't need certain times to come to pray. We don't need certain condition to pray. We don't need difficulties and the problem to have to pray. We don't need to be in a certain age to pray. All the time is the best time to pray. We have to accept. Do you know, brothers and sisters, when we have hardship and hard time and the pray, only on that time and we never prayed before, that prayer will not prevent the hardship, the trial, the difficulty which you face. But if you were praying before, and even, you had no hardship, no hard time, the prayer will protect you from the hardship. That is saying, when the hardship, the trial come to you, and when your prayer goes up, and that will meet with each other, the prayer will stop, the trial to come down upon you. Till the day of judgment will never come down to you. That is the benefit of the prayer. And the prayer stop the trials, preventing hardship, And do you know, brothers, sisters, as the believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never promised us we will not be in a trial. Allah promised us to be in a trial. But the dua, Allah asks us to make a dua to stop and freeze and protect yourself from the trials. This is the way. When you pray and you have no trials, no difficulties, no problems, then if you got it, when you pray because you got some difficulties, some trials and the problems, your prayer will go through. The angels will say this prayer, this voice, this sound, we are familiar with it. The prayer of saving yourself, getting help from the difficulties which you face it. And your prayer will go through. The angels will allow your prayer to go through, will never break it, will never stop it. Then when it goes through, the response will come back to you. But if you never prayed before, and you had the trials, difficulties, hardship, hard time, and then you pray, you start to pray, the angel will say, this voice is strange voice. We never hear about it. They will never allow the voice to go through. Why? Because you never prayed before. Therefore, I don't need to wait for the difficulties, for the trial, for the problems. Then I start to pray. No, surely I have to protect myself from the condition which I am in it by the prayer. Do you know, brothers and sisters, the hadith said that when the trial comes, even you are so careful, whenever you cannot stop the qadr. Qadr, qada'u qadr, you cannot stop it. Even you are so careful, driving, for example, so careful, but there's an accident, you have to face it. Even you are careful, somebody else will come and hit you. But by the dua, even if you are not careful, you'll be protected. Okay, this qada wa qadar will be away from you. But that is what the Ahlul Bayt Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us. Being careful is not enough. We need the dua. Okay, by the dua we need to protect ourselves. We have so many things, we need for so many things, and there is no other way other than dua. Brothers, dua has a lot of things. You know, by the dua I will learn to know about my Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's important, because you cannot ask somebody you don't know him. By the dua, in the dua, you will know who is he. He is the one who has everything in the hand. He has the knowledge, he has the power, he can reach, he can help, okay? He listens, he looks, he knows every, all these things you know. But when you make a dua, therefore, brothers and sisters, dua really means I know who is he. And by dua, I get the blessing and the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And by the dua, I will be humble to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No arrogant man can ask Allah. The humble one, he will ask Allah. No hard heart can ask Allah. The soft heart will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By the dua, we can reach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and gain the guidance. Dua has a lot of benefit for us. Enlighten me for the future. Provide me hope. Okay? Give me guidance. Okay? And support. Gain support from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And really, show me what is wrong. Where is wrong? When I read the dua, I will look at the dua. See, it is the lesson for me. What thing make you have problems? What thing is wrong not to do it? By the dua I will learn all these things. Read all the dua Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and even the ad'i of the Quran al-Kareem, or the dua of the A'imma, dua Kumail, Jawshan, Asharat, Nudba, all the dua provide me information. What things really I will make me in trouble? Or wrong things, I should not do it. What things, right things, I should do it. Dua fix all the shortage and fix the relationship between me and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, between me and the others. I have to learn many things. In the prayer, when I am would like to say the prayer, I have to know. I have to know there are certain things I need to do. First, knows who is Allah. If I don't really know Allah well, or when I communicate with Allah, my mind is not there, I will not get any response. Okay, I will not get any response because Allah will not pay attention to the one who is not paying attention to whatever he is saying to Allah. Whenever you talk to Allah, bring your mind there, understand that you are talking, to whom you are talking. And then you will be gaining the response. The only astajibility. And besides this, whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks us to do not ignore it. Be serious. Accept it. Deal with it. Okay, whatever order Allah order you, deal with that. Okay? Accept it. Practice it. Because as He promised, okay, we promise too. And why he should keep his promise to respond positive to the dua, okay, when we call him. But we are not really should keep our promise. Allah has said clearly, you keep your promise, I keep my promise. Ufi bi'adi, ufi bi'adi. Okay, when you keep your promise, I will keep my promise. That's true. That's fair. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is ready to keep His promise. When I am keeping my promise, I have the promise. I am the one who worship Allah, He is the Lord, and I love my religion, and I follow Islam. I should, keep this promise. Okay? I submit myself to Allah. I should keep this promise. When I keep this promise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep his promise too. Therefore, when we are making dua, there is some adab manner in the dua. After all, manners. Has to start any dua, we have to start by Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Any dua, we have to start by the Tanjeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tanjeed. Tanjeed means what? Means everything put Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in it. Ya man huwa aqrabu min habl al-wareed. Ya man huwa aqrabu min kulli shay. Alim bi kulli shay. Tanjeed Allah. Talk greatness about the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who is Allah? Okay? When you talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, knows who is Allah, that's dua will go through, your dua will go through. Okay? Besides that, involve and relate to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Oh, salli ala Muhammad.
Okay? When you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ask by the Muhammad and Ali Muhammad, because we are sinners, and they are the ones who can really support. And Allah look at them different than look at us. When you involve them, make, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pray, you pray. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pray for Muhammad and Ali Muhammad. That will help. Okay. When you say Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Ali Muhammad. Allahumma bihaqqi Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. Okay. When you remember Muhammad and Ali Muhammad in the dua, that's your dua will be go through. It will help. Brothers and sisters, most important things, do dua together. Unfortunately, many of us, we don't come to the dua to make. We don't have a unite dua. Although we should. Okay, we have dua to make. Okay, this is the dua of Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib. Beautiful dua. And if you do it together, surely the response will be for guarantee. Allah will love you. Okay? Allah will love you when you come together and do it. We need to come to dua and attend. Don't say, I don't need anything to ask Allah. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect you, to save you, to offer you good place in the paradise and the hereafter. Okay, we are in the time, we need a dua. Brothers and sisters, there are many people in the world are suffering today. They need your dua, you can't do nothing, you cannot help them. But they need your dua, and your dua can change. Your dua can help them. Okay, and that is really what we need to do. When you come together, your dua will come, go through. Four people, Imam Sadiq salamullahi alayhi, when four people come together, make a dua together, their dua will go through. Allah will respond positive to them. And Imam Sadiq salamullahi alayhi, what he was doing, he was putting the all together the kids, and he was asking Allah, Imam, he can sit alone and can ask Allah. He put his kids, his women all together, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what he looked for, and all the women and the kids saying, Ameen. May Allah accept. May Allah accept. Okay? Do that too if you cannot come. Okay? Every night, do it in your home, and keep your kids, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and let them respond positively, saying, pray with you too. Okay? That's another way of the dua will go through. Do not leave Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Allah everything in each matter. Surely Allah will be available for you. Brothers and sisters, we need to gain benefit from whatever Allah offering us. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد اللهم اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الخلائق أجمعين محمد وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين الأطهار، لا سيما أمير المؤمنين وسيد الوصيين وإمام المتقين علي عليه الصلاة والسلام وفاطمة الزهراء والإمامان الحسن والحسين سيدا شباب أهل الجنة، وعلي بن الحسين زين العابدين، ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى الرضا ومحمد بن علي الجواد وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي والحجة المهدي عجل الله تعالى فرجه وسهل الله مخرجه، جعل الله من أنصاره وأعوانه ومن المستشهدين بين يديه. عباد الله، أوصي نفسي أولا بتقوى الله سبحانه وتعالى، وأوصيكم بذلك. Brothers and sisters, I advise myself first to have fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I advise you too. Brothers and sisters, fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means whatever Allah offering us, take it as a serious matter. Do not ignore it. Do not put it for the later on. Because you are the one who has fear of Allah. Because you have fear of Allah, and Allah has said something to do, you do it. Okay? Anybody you have fear of him, you have fear of him. If he asks you to do something, he will do it. Out of your fear. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he asks us to do something, okay, why we should not do it? Because we don't have fear of Allah. Because we do not, abuse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is not right. This is not fair. We have to have fear of Allah and do everything, whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks us to do, we have to do it. One of the important things, dua. He asks us to make a dua, du'uni, astajib lakum. Do not wait for the hard time, okay? To ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah love you when you are praying, when you have an easy time, nice time. Okay? And Imam al-Hasan salamullahi alayh has said, أَنَا الضَّامِنُ لِمَنْ لَمْ يَهْجِسُ فِي قَلْبِهِ إِلَّا رِضَى أَنْ يَدْعُ اللَّهَ فَيُسْتَجَابُ لَهُ. I am the one who give you guarantee to the one he has nothing in his heart other than satisfaction. Okay? About Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He never argue against Allah. Well, okay? Whatever Allah does to you, accept it with the satisfaction. Imam said, I will give you guarantee when you pray, your prayer will go through. When you don't argue, when you do not disagree with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your prayer will go through. You know, Imam al-Hasan salamullahi alayhi, these days, seven of Safar, the shahada of Imam al-Hasan salamullahi alayhi. Imam al-Hasan, he had hard time. Every day for him was Karbala. Really was Karbala. He has to face Bani Umayyah and Shurud Bani Umayyah, Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan. It's the head of the Bani Umayyah, the brain of the Bani Umayyah, the snake of Bani Umayyah. He has to face him and destroy his plan, the plan of Bani Umayyah, to kill the name of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa
sallam.
To destroy, to move the name of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One day a man came to him, and he was congratulating Muawiyah because he won the war against Ali ibn Abi Talib. Muawiyah never, he is not happy. He said, what's wrong with you? You are not happy? He said, listen, Muazzin Azzin. He said, this is the name of Muhammad is there. Still, I fight Ali, but I could not remove the name of Muhammad. He is not happy because the name of Muhammad is still there on the his mosque, he cannot remove it. That's the plan. Okay? And he was working against the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Imam al-Hasan salamullahi alayhi, he has to face such man with his own conspiracy and the plan. Surely Imam al-Hasan succeeded. He did what he has to do. He kept the believers safe and secure. He did work until show the people there is two, okay? There is two leaders. One is false leaders, Muawiyah, for the dunya, and the other leaders for the akhirah, Al-Hasan ibn Ali. He just survived, just keep his name there and resist communicating with the people, teaching people, informing people. He's the grandson and he is not, he disagrees with Muawiyah. That's the biggest struggle. And when Muawiyah could not handle whatever Imam al-Hasan he was doing, Muawiyah planned to kill Imam al-Hasan. Even he had agreement, peace agreement with him. Why? Because Muawiyah does not want people to know there is two leaders. One for dunya, one for akhirah. One for shaitan, one for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Muawiyah wants everybody knows, recognize Muawiyah, he is the leader. He is the man who can decide for their dunya, for their religion, for their akhirah. That's what Muawiyah wants. And Imam al-Hasan salamullahi alayhi stopped Muawiyah. Okay? He could not, he challenged Muawiyah to reach to this plan. Therefore, brothers and sisters, Imam al-Hasan asked us, man, although he had the hardship time, but he was pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the one who said, Ad-dunya sijn al-mu'min. The dunya, this life, is the prison for the believers. Prison for the believers. This is the way of life of Muhammad, of Imam al-Hasan salamullah alayhi. Brothers and sisters, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said,
Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
Ta'arraf ala Allah fi rakha ya'rifuka fi shidda. Learn about Allah. Communicate with Allah. Okay? Pray to Allah while you are in the nice time. While you are thinking you don't need any financial help, any medical help, okay, no problems in your life. In such a time, you communicate with Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reach you when you are in the hardship. Okay? When you recognize Allah, communicate with Allah, in the easy time, okay, Allah will, subhanahu wa ta'ala, will reach you when you have hard time and hardship. And Imam al-Hasan salamullahi alayhi has said, مَا فَتَحَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلْ عَلَىٰ أَحَدٍ بَابِ مَسْأَلَةٍ فَخَزَنَ عَنْهُ بَابُ الْإِجَابَةِ فَخَزَنَ عَنْهُ بَابُ الْإِجَابَةِ Imam has said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never opened a gate for you, okay, to ask, okay, that's question. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the one, he is opening for us. And when you just sitting here say, God, you feel there is communication start between you and Allah. You believe the, and you feel there is answer, say, what do you need? Okay? And certainly when your heart is soft, okay, when you are a sincere man, okay, our Imam said, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the one who asks you, okay, to ask him, he will never block the gate of response. He would just, he is not only one, he asks you to ask and he will not give you, provide you. No, when you ask him, he is ready, okay, to respond, because he is the one who asks you to ask. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, اعلموا ان الله لا يستجيب دعاء من قلب غافل. You have to know, Allah will never respond positive to the any dua from the one his heart is not there when he is asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You read dua to me, but you don't know what is going on, what you are talking, what you are asking. يريد أن يدعى after the prayer. You don't know what is this the meaning of this dua. What you are asking Allah. Okay, that means your mind, your heart is not there. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not respond to your dua. You will miss the answer. We need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala need you to put your dua, your mind there to understand. الإمام الباقر سلام الله عليه إن الله عز وجل كره إلحاح الناس بعضهم على بعض. Allah dislike when you ask somebody many times, insist to ask somebody, okay, friend, relative, whoever he is, okay, في المسألة وأحب ذلك لنفسه. But Allah like when you ask him many times, one subject. But many times you ask him, okay? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he likes that because when he does not like somebody, does not mean he does not like it for himself. Allah likes it for himself. Therefore, brothers and sisters, do not ask one time. Keep asking many times, okay? When you are in foreign, when you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran al-Kareem, ask all of you, man, okay, to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about saving your kids. Because in such an age, hard for you to do something for your kids. But need dua involving Allah. Allah will help for your kids. Okay? Do that. Al-Imam As-Sadiq Salamullahi Alayhi has said, when somebody has his heart become soft, whatever reason, he's in the mosque, he gets heart soft. He gets certain conditions, okay, somewhere he was, some news make him have certain good, soft heart. Imam said, in that occasion, pray. Do not miss Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pray to him. فَإِنَّ الْقَلْبِ لَا يُوَقُّ حَتَّى يَخْلُصْ. Because your heart will never be soft till you become sincere man about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your relationship with Allah, your communication with Allah become so sincere, then your heart becomes soft. The arrogant man, the one who is the hypocrite man, never get the soft in his heart. But when you gain your heart soft for whatever reason, okay, that means you really become sincere man, with a sincere relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Take advantage from such occasion, okay, sometime Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his light reach your heart and your heart accepted, okay, positively, and really you'll be so humble and so humble to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, such a time, such a minute, such a time, take advantage and communicate with Allah. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your prayer will go through. Brothers and sisters, we need to pray. Okay, anytime. Do not wait for the hardship, hard time, okay, to come to pray. No, stop the hard time, the trial by the pain. Help the others by praying. Guide the others by praying for them. Prayer is necessary for all of us. A'imma salamullahi alayhim, they were praying. Okay, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was praying. At the night, every night, okay, Rasulullah, he was awake all the night, praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He does not need anything, but he was praying, okay, to really communicate with Allah better, be more close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah love you when you pray to him. May Allah bless all of you. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Inna a'tainaka al-kawthar. Fasalli li rabbika wanhar. Inna shani'aka huwa al-abtar. Nas'aluka Allahumma wa nad'uka bismika al-azim al-a'zam. Al-'azz al-ajal al-akram. Ya Allah, ya Allah, ya Allah. Ya Rahman, ya Rahim, ya muqallib al-qulub wal-absar. Thabbit qulubana wa absarana ala dinik. Allahumma la nagham ilayka fi dawlatin kareema. Tu'izz biha al-islam wa ahla. Wa tudhill biha an-nifaq wa ahla. Wa taj'alna fiha min ad-du'ati ila ta'atik. Wa al-qadati ila sabilik. Wa tarzuqna biha karamat ad-dunya wal-akhirah. Bi rahmatik ya arhamar rahimin. Wa sallallahu ala Muhammadin wa alihi al-tahirin.